Did you know that if you hold the alt on a PC or option on a Mac key and click on the frequency spectrum, in this case we're a Neutron 2's equalizer, you have an audio magnifying glass. This lets you hear only the frequencies that are under the mouse cursor without affecting the actual EQ settings. This is really useful for pinpointing the location of a frequency in the mix without changing your actual EQ bands. So let's say we want to do some subtractive EQing, and I was looking for a resonant frequency here. I could decide that it's here, let go, and double click. And now I've automatically assigned an EQ node to that area. And now I can dip out that frequency. We can change the default bandwidth of this filter in the options menu. Go over here, EQ, so I can set it to a very narrow Q if I wanted to. Looks like this. Or go very wide. Looks like that. I'll double click to return it to its default setting. So this doesn't just work across our mixing and mastering plugins on the EQ level. It works on our creative plugins as well. So on the bass, for example, I have an instance of Trash 2. Same thing. I'll solo this so we can hear it. I'm on my filter 1. I can do the same thing on a mastering level. Let's say I wanted to listen for a particular instrument in the frequency spectrum of the entire stereo track. I can open up Ozone 8 and scrub around to find it. Double click and make a little boost. It also works in tonal balance control. Not just in the fine view, but the broad view as well. So, now you know that option or alt click on a EQ frequency spectrum in many of our plugins gives you an audio magnifying glass.